Hello, today I'm going to show you a random loot. It is popular for all RPGs and action games that have item drops. And at the end of this tutorial, you can make a random drop from enemies, treasure chests, and so on. There are mainly three parts of this tutorial: a single item drop, a random loot with equal weight, and a random loot with weight. Okay, and here we are in Game Builder Garage. In this tutorial, I'm going to make a random loot from this fluffball, but feel free to change this into treasure chests or other enemies. Okay, first, I'm going to show you how to make a single item drop. So here I have a fluffball and it should drop an item after it is killed. But what should it drop? In this case, let's say I want it to drop an apple. So I'm going to create an apple first. The next question is, when should we drop an item? We should drop an item when the fluffball is destroyed. So here we need a destroyed sensor to detect that. And I'm going to connect this one to the fluffball. Go to the settings, remove visible. This destroyed sensor will send a constant output 1 when fluffball is destroyed. Okay. When the fluffball is destroyed, we have to teleport an apple to the middle of fluffball. Here we need to add a teleport exit. This is the location that the apple will appear after the fluffball is killed. Yeah, now we have an exit. We also need an entrance. So I'm going to add a teleport entrance. And we need to teleport an apple, so I have to connect this one to an apple. Then I go to the settings. And then for teleport words, I'm going to change it to teleport an apple. Make sure that the teleport ID matches the teleport exit at the fluffball. Remove visible, close it. So when the fluffball is destroyed, we should teleport an apple. Let's see. Okay, let's try killing this fluffball together. But the problem is that the physics of the apple is a bit weird, right? That's because this destroyed sensor keeps sending output 1. So the apple keeps teleporting itself here and it slows down how the apple is falling. So we have to remove this link between the destroyed sensor and teleport. And then we change to trigger instead. I'm sending an output from the discharge sensor to trigger and connect the output of the trigger to teleport entrance. So what happens here is that the discharge sensor will send out a constant output 1, but the trigger will send a short signal like 1 and then 0, so the teleport will happen only once. Okay, let's see how it works. Yeah, now the physics of apple is normal, correct? Yeah, and we are done if we only have a single item drop. But we are going to add a random item drop. So yeah, let's continue. Before we continue, let's remove this link between the trigger and the teleport entrance. Let's say that I also want a fluffball to drop a turnip and also a tiny fluffball. So I'm going to create those first. Yeah, so now we have 3 different items. We also need 3 teleport entrance. 1 for each. And don't forget to connect them to the fancy objects. Then we have to go to each teleport entrance settings. Make sure that we teleport a correct object. So in this case, it is turnip. And the third one is teleporting a fluffball. Now that I have got 3 items and I want one of them to appear randomly, I need a random nodon to generate a number from 1 to 3, and if the number is 1, I will drop an apple. If the number is 2, I will drop a turnip, and if the number is 3, I will drop a fluffball. So yeah, let's create a random nodon. Then I'm going to do the settings, Update timing is on change from 0 because we only need to randomize one number. The output range is 3 because we have got 3 items. Close it. And we have to random a number when an object is destroyed. From here, you can also use a comparison node on. Like for example, when this value is 1, I will drop an apple. But I'm going to show you how to do it with a marker node on. So going to output, other marker display and move. So basically there are 4 values like 0, 1, 2, 3. So I have to make sure that this move marker node on can fit 4 squares. This one represents 0 value, it means no drop. 1 means an apple, 2 means a turnip, and 3 means a fluffball. Then we need a map between a random node on and a move marker node on. Connect a random node on to map and a map to move marker node on. Then we are going to the map settings to make sure that the output here is from 0 to 1. So we have to change the input range to be from 0 to 3 and the output range is from 0 to 1. Yes. So now when a random value is 1, the square will move here and we will have to drop an apple. So we need a bullseye node on to read the value here. And when this is true, I have to teleport an apple. Let's repeat this for a turnip and a fluffball as well. When the random value is 2, it will be mapped to this position and I will drop a turnip. Okay, and the last one is for the tiny fluffball. Let's take a look. Yeah, so now we have that weird physics again. The problem here is that this random does not go back to 0. So the item keeps teleporting itself and floating in the air. So yeah, we need to use this trigger to reset the random value. So what will happen here is that after a fluffball is destroyed, I will random a number 1, 2 or 3. And then this trigger will quickly reset it to be 0. So yeah, the teleport will happen only once and the item will no longer float in the air. Okay, let's try it. Yes, it works. Let's try again and see what we can get. Yeah, a turnip. Now we can randomly get either one of the 3 items. If you want items to drop at different rates, there are a few modifications to do. We have to change the random node on to output range 999. Close it. And from the map, we have to change the input range to be from 0 to 1000. Also, we have to change the marker into line marker node on. Now, when an item is destroyed, a line will appear at anywhere on this line marker node on. The fourth step is to change all the bullseye into rectangle. So now the size of this marker means 100% drop. If you expand this bullseye by half, it will mean that that particular item has 50% chance of dropping. Yeah, so you can use this and resize the bullseye marker to get the drop rate that you want. So in this case, like, we have highest chance of dropping an apple and slightly smaller chance for dropping a turnip and a really slim chance to drop a fluffball. Okay, let's test. This is our first attempt. An apple. An apple again. But like, if I continue for a while, I can also get a fluffball. So to summarize, in this tutorial, I have shown you how to make a single item drop. Second, I have shown you how to make a random loot with equal probabilities. And the third one, like, I have shown you how to add weight to your properties. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. And if you wonder how I animate the Pikachu, feel free to check my previous tutorials on 4-directional animation tutorial. Lastly, please like, share, and subscribe. Bye bye! I have to go kill more fluff balls to get more apples. See ya!